Hello everyone. Now we are studying about the access modifiers in Java. There are the two types of the access modifiers in Java: access modifiers and second the non-access modifiers. The access modifiers in Java specifies accessibility, that is scope of a data members, method, constructor or class. So now we see the different types of the access modifiers here. There are the four types of the Java access modifiers. First, private, default, protected, and public. Now see the first one, access modifier. The private access modifier is accessible only within the class. Second, the default access modifier. If you don't use any modifier, then it is treated as a default modifier. By default, the default modifier is accessible only within the package. Third access modifier is the protected. The protected access modifier is accessible within the package, and outside the package it can be accessed through inheritance only. Then the protected access modifier can be applied on the data member, method and the constructor. It cannot be applied on the class. Next modifier is the public. The public access modifier is accessible everywhere and it has the widest scope among all the modifiers. Now we are studying only two modifiers here, one by one. First modifier is the private and second is the protected. Okay, and the remaining modifiers you should try yourself. So our first modifier here is the private modifier. Okay, now see in this program, there is a package SECSC, and in that package there is a class named demo is created, and in that there is one variable, that is data, is declared whose type is the integer and whose access modifier is the private. And so we can say that it cannot be accessed outside the class because its access modifier is the private. So its scope is within the class only. Next, there is one method is also defined whose access modifier is the private also. Oh, so we cannot say that the variable data, we can say that the variable data and the method show cannot be accessed outside the class because its scope is within the class demo only. And if anyone try to access these private data members outside the class, then there will be a compile time error. Error will generate. Okay. Now see here, there is a class named private access modifier here. And in that, the main method is declared. And in that main method, the object D1 of the demo class is created. And by using this object, the private member we are trying to access. D1.data, and we are trying also the show method, that is which is private. So now you can see what will happen when I will run this program. Okay, then this run file, and you can see there is the compile time error. Okay, because we are trying to access the private data members in the class private access modifier. So there is a error is generated, that is compile time error is generated. Next our next modifier is the protected access modifier. Then first see the program is, there is a next, I have created one package, that is mypack, and in that mypack I have created one class, that is base class. So see here, there is a base class. So I have already told about the protected access modifier. So check our program directly. I have created a new package called a mypack. This is a mypack, and in that the class base is created. And in that base class, I have defined one method that is show, and whose access modifier is the protected here. Whose access modifier is the protected here, and in that there is a simple println statement to display the message welcome. Now in the base class, Now let's see here the subclass of this base class, which is created into another package, that is SECSE. So the method of there is a method shown whose access modifier is protected. So it can be accessed outside the package and outside the class, but only within the subclass of this base class. And the base class access modifier is also public, so it can be also accessed outside the class. So see here in the projects, there is a package SECSE, and in that I have created the protected access modifier class. So there is a package SECSE here, and there is a we are importing here. Now see the package, so see this statement here, the import statement, which is used to import the earlier created package, that is mypack, and the base class which is created, and the base class which is created in that package. So the class is protected access modifier, which is the subclass of base class, and in the main method the object of this class is created, and by using this object we can access the method show here. So we can see the output. See here the message will be displayed, this is welcome, which we have created in the another package, that is mypack, and there is a class base class. See here, this is the statement welcome which is printed after running the file. Okay, thank you.